Hi everyone, it's the third Sunday of Easter and we're here still in our Easter white. Can you think of times when you've not recognized someone you know well at first? What happened? You were probably thinking, oh, they were too far away or they were dressed differently so I didn't recognize them until they started speaking. After Jesus rose from the dead, even people who had been close to him sometimes didn't recognize him at first. In today's gospel, we hear about two of Jesus's disciples and how they came to recognize Jesus. So let's listen. A reading from the Gospel of Luke. May Christ's words be on my mind, on my lips, and in my heart. It was the first day of the week when Mary Magdalene and the other women went to the tomb of Jesus and found it empty. That same day, two of the other disciples were on their way to a little village called Emmaus. They were talking about all that had happened to Jesus. While they were walking, Jesus himself came along and walked with them. But the two disciples didn't recognize him. Jesus asked them, "What have you been talking about?" They looked very sad, and one of them, Cleophas, said, "You must be the only visitor in Jerusalem who hasn't heard about the things that have happened." Jesus asked, "What things?" And they said, "Jesus of Nazareth was a great prophet who did and said many powerful things in front of all the people. We were hoping that he was the one who would save us, but our chief priests and rulers put him to death. They crucified him 3 days ago, and early this morning, some of the women from our group went to the tomb, but they couldn't find his body. They ran back saying some angels told them Jesus is alive. Then some of the men went to the tomb and found it exactly as the women had said, and they didn't see Jesus either." Then Jesus said, "You are so foolish. Why don't you believe what the prophets said? They told you that the Christ would have to suffer and die before coming into his glory." Then Jesus explained everything that Moses and the prophets had said about him. When they got close to Emmaus, the two disciples said to Jesus, "It's almost evening. Stay with us." So he stayed with them, and while they were at the table, Jesus took the bread, blessed it, and broke it, and gave it to them. Then they understood, and they recognized him. But Jesus disappeared from their sight. The two disciples said to each other, "Remember how excited we were when he talked to us on the road explaining the scriptures?" The two ran to Jerusalem to tell the others everything Jesus had told them and how they recognized him in the breaking of the bread. The Gospel of the Lord. We all say praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. So what were the two disciples doing when Jesus approached them? They were leaving Jerusalem and they were talking about Jesus's death. Why do you think the disciples were leaving Jerusalem? And maybe, what were their thoughts and feelings? They were probably leaving Jerusalem because they were scared. And they probably, you know, just wanted to get away before something might happen to them. Did the disciples recognize Jesus as he approached them? No, they didn't. What did the two disciples talk about with Jesus as they walked? They talked about Jesus, his death, and their hopes that he would be the one to save them. And then how does Jesus respond to them? Jesus asked the disciples to tell him about what had happened, and then he interprets or explains those events for them using the scripture, the Old Testament stories that they all knew so well. And then they had a meal together. And what happens during that meal? Jesus blesses the bread and breaks it and shares it with his disciples. And in that moment, the disciples recognize that the stranger is Jesus himself. And then what did the disciples do after that? They don't just walk back to Jerusalem. They run back to Jerusalem to tell the other disciples what has happened because they are so excited. What would have you said to the risen Jesus if you had recognized him? What questions might you have asked him? You know, I think for me, I would have said, how did you do that? And explain to me more how these stories from the Old Testament and how what happened to you fulfills what happened. When Jesus broke the bread with his disciples, they recognized that Jesus had truly risen and was with them. We can recognize that Jesus is always with us, even when we can't see him. You know, whenever we celebrate Mass, we recognize that Jesus is present to us in the Word and in a very special way in the Eucharist. Like the disciples on the road to Emmaus, at the end of the Eucharist, we are sent to share the good news of Jesus with others. We go and announce the gospel of the Lord. How is it that we can do that? You know, we announce the presence of our Lord in the way we care for our friends and family, in sharing the things we have with those that are in need, and when we pray for others as well. So with that in mind, let us pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. And the response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray that the church may, with courage, answer the call of our risen Christ and proclaim his message with joy and hope. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for all of our world leaders and all people throughout the world that we may work together to preserve our planet and all of its resources. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for the families in our parish community, that we might all embrace the light of Christ this Easter season and live with renewed faith, hope, and love. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And just a final quick little prayer to finish with today. Jesus, we rejoice because you are our Lord and Savior. You are with us always, even to the end of time. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. See you soon, everyone.